Hello, this is Sachin Labde once again. This time, I'll be discussing with you one of the essential components of the third module on perspective on curriculum design. In the previous session, we had discussion on a crucial and essential phase in curriculum design and development, namely to determine and agree the national and regional context in which the program is to be developed and delivered. In this session, we will move a step further. What one can expect from this session? Well, there are many factors that go into the making of curriculum. This dynamic of curriculum includes stakeholders such as learners, teachers, administrators, policymakers, and beneficiaries, such as industries, public and private service institutions. In this session, we will focus on learner-centric aspects. This session will discuss two aspects central to the objectives of curriculum. One, defining the needs of the learners in line with the requirement of profession which they may pursue, and determining the aims and broad learning outcomes of the program. Before we take up this particular aspect to discuss, let us first try and reconsider our notion of higher education. In terms of level, higher education includes college and university teaching learning towards which students progress to attain higher educational qualification. Higher education imparts in-depth knowledge and understanding so as to advance the students to new frontiers of knowledge in different walks of life, that is their subject domains. The educationist Ronald Barnett presents a manifold concept of higher education. Firstly, higher education is perceived in terms of the production of qualified human resources. In this view, higher education is eyed as a process in which the students are counted as products, and higher education becomes input to the growth and development of business and industry. The second notion is higher education is seen as training for a research career. Higher education in this light is seen as the preparation for qualified scientists and researchers who develop the frontiers of knowledge ceaselessly. Further, higher education is perceived as the efficient management of teaching provision. Imparting knowledge forms the core of educational institutions. Thus, higher education institutions focus on efficient management of teaching learning provisions by improving the quality of teaching, hence enabling a higher completion rate among the students. If we look at higher education system of India, we realize that it has the immense responsibility to prepare the youth of the nation to contribute towards nation building so that this country realizes its true potential. Higher education needs to be looked at from the multiple stakeholder perspectives. A curriculum to be designed for the purpose of building employability of the students, enhancing entrepreneurial orientation, and inculcating sensitivity towards societal needs. A good curriculum design in higher education needs to be geared up towards all these objectives. Now, I would like you to pause this video once again and take a look at this question. Who do you consider the stakeholders in higher education who may affect and be affected by the curriculum? Make a list and also write down why you considered someone to be the stakeholder. After doing so, you can resume the video. Having given a thought to the question which was presented, you must have made a list of stakeholders which include learners, teachers, beneficiaries, which we mentioned earlier, the institutions as managers. Now we will take a look at how these stakeholders affect or influence curriculum designing or curriculum development. But before that, let us go back to the notion of curriculum. I'm sure that we had discussion on the term curriculum, but let us try and generalize the idea of curriculum once again. There is a shared understanding that despite multiple definitions of curriculum, it can be seen as an overall plan for instruction. It consists of a statement of aims and objectives of content in terms of theoretical knowledge, practical skills to be acquired, attitude towards work, and necessary support materials to be used in its presentation. Curriculum development has long been regarded as a core component of education, and more so of higher education.